I'm excited. When you had stepped away, I was talking to the folks at home just saying, you know, shout out to both of these guys. 3-0, 2-1-1 for fighting each other. It's exactly what we talked about. They're neither fighter's taking an easy fight here.
No. Evenly matched, good fight by two young men.
Big left lands by the Irishman.
Khalil Mitchell, just coming back from Mexico, was down there with Canelo Alvarez in camp.
Really?
Yes.
He was in camp with him?
He was in camp down there with Alvarez because Canelo fights this weekend also.
Yeah, oh, that's got to be confidence building, right?
Absolutely.
You're in there with one of the best fighters, maybe the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world today.
Routinely, he's with Avius Griffin and Ryan Martin out in Nevada.
Wow.
Out in Las Vegas.
Huh.
Burke being careful.
That was a slip. Yeah.
That was a slip.
Maybe a little elbow, too.
Rubin's racing.
Big right.
So, Khalil's been jabbing to the body. He jabbed to the body, and Burke caught him with that uppercut coming in. Double jab missed with the left hand by Khalil Mitchell. I like Mitchell flipping that jab out there.
Yeah, from the southpaw stance.
Yeah,
he's
throwing it from his waist. It's almost like coming up. Another jab to the body, another one. Nice for Mitchell. Looking sharp. Burke missed a big right hand.
You'd like to see Burke stay within himself, maybe not throw those kind of bombs just quite yet. Fights early on, feel it out, feel Mitchell out. He's fighting a tough fighter who is landing and landing.
I think those shots were blocked. They were, you know, got the crowd excited, but let's make sure they land.
It's fair.
There's a left hand. That's a counter land that landed on the chin of Burke.
And Burke is taking steps backwards. He needs to gather himself after that left lands to the jaw.
Maybe having a little problem figuring out the southpaw stance of Khalil Mitchell.
Well, and but a big right figures out the jaw of Mitchell. Burke landing his first serious, significant shot of the evening. Mitchell's got a twitchy demeanor, right? His movement is a little unorthodox. He's moving a lot in, out, left, right. Pretty hard to figure out his timing. Giving Burke some feints. Burke finding a home for that right.
Burke appears a little bit more polished in the boxing. Khalil, you know, he's holding his own. He's got his guard high. See, when he throws that left hand, though, he's got to bring that right back up.
Boy, that jab's fast.
Big right hand by Khalil Mitchell.
Burke is staggered. Watch Burke because he is on Dream Street right now, and he's taking three shots. Oh, and he fights back. The Irishman is tough. Boy, he got hit hard. Credit to him. This guy can take a shot. Most guys are on their back right now after the shot Burke just took.
Good matchup here.
This is fun, man. You guys put some great fights together tonight. Tell you what.
This is what boxing should be. This is what the fans want.
I agree.
This is what the fans want. This is what people at home want.
Yeah, it is so true, man. It's really fun to see a matchup like this where both guys are skilled, talented fighters.
The beautiful ITK ring girls in there. Look at Miss Addison strutting her stuff.
What does ITK stand for?
I'll tell you when we're off air.
Oh, okay.
ITK is a fraternity that was made.
Oh.
And when, you know that I...
thought you were going to tell me off air. This feels like you're telling me on air.
I'm gonna just tease everybody at home. You know, Southpaw Promotions... The flagship company has got a contract with Sports World Television down in Atlanta.
Yep.
So Southpaw Promotions, Billy, cannot take that name outside of Atlanta with there. But we are doing other regional boxing shows like this, and we'll have some coming up in some other neighboring
states.
Can't
take the name Southpaw?
Southpaw is contractually tied with Sports World Television in Atlanta.
Which we got that coming up in a few weeks, huh? That's going
to
be exciting.
We do. And so let's go to round two here.
Speaking of exciting, Burke coming out. These fighters are great. Really bringing the action.
So Khalil Mitchell has no respect for Robert Burke. I think he has felt his power.
Yeah. Good point, Billy. Oh, and he staggers him again. Staggers Burke, but to Burke's credit, he's still standing. He's still on his feet, but boy, those legs look wobbly. Oh,
another right hand by Khalil Mitchell lands.
Khalil Mitchell has power. I don't like. Oh Burke's disposition is showing me, man, he is really, really close. He's getting, get that little break will help. Let's see him throw more straight punches. These wild looping punches are leaving him open for those counters.
Mitchell's had the most success off the counter.
He snaps his jab about as fast as anybody I've seen. And like you said, it comes from kind of a non-traditional angle. So it's coming up at Burke instead of straight from the shoulder. Mitchell beginning to unload.
Right hand by Burke lands. Does not faze Mitchell. Mitchell's content to sit in the pocket and trade.
To your point, he's not scared to get hit.
Yeah, he's not afraid of Burke's power.
Lands again.
Another
with
counter left.
Yeah.
Both fighters in their throwing.
Boys are giving the fans what they want. Tell you what. Oh, and look at Burke. Giving him a little shove.
Burke, the true Irishman.
Danny Zamba stepping in. Wants a little break
Burke
in the action.
With a shot to the body.
Now Mitchell's swinging
Does
wildly.
Khalil Mitchell have enough in the gas tank to go six rounds at this pace? I think he's probably out throwing Burke 2-1. He's landing. He's winning rounds, right?
No question.
But does he have the gas tank to sustain? But
big,
nice body shot followed
body
by
shot
a left
by
hook.
Burke. You can hear that body shot all throughout the arena. But these guys are fighting. This is fun.
So I counted five punches thrown by Khalil Mitchell. None of them landed. Burke's staying small. He's staying tight behind those gloves.
Yeah, good point, Billy. It's not always the things that get the oohs and the ahs from the crowd that are going to win the fight, right?
Big left hook.
But that'll get an ooh and an ah. And we got our first knockdown of the fight. Burke right back to his feet. We're at the 7 count, 8. But he is still wobbled. Let's see if Mitchell. Oh, saved by the bell.
Wow.
He was lucky with that timing. Tell you
Khalil
what,
Mitchell with that
tough
combination at the end of round two for a 10-8 round. Wow.
27 years old, 6 foot tall. I like this Khalil Mitchell.
Khalil Mitchell, I've seen him in his previous two fights. He fought journeyman fighters. Didn't look as polished as he does tonight. The time that he's spending in Vegas, the time he's spending around his mentors is paying off.
If you're in the ring with Canelo Alvarez, you're going to get better, right? I mean, no question about it.
I can't hold up, man.
We're going to see what they can take here in round three. As the two fighters come out, let them know that you are in that building.
Yeah, so being around those, that quality of competition, that quality of mentorship is obviously making a difference in Khalil Mitchell's career from the last time we saw him in Ringgold, Georgia, to tonight in Chattanooga, Tennessee.
Was the 1 minute layoff enough to get Burke his legs back? We'll see.
Well, Khalil Mitchell does not look winded.
No.
You know, I questioned his gas tank, but when you get that moment, right hand by Mitchell.
Wow, he's going body head, beautiful. Mitchell's doing what he wants. He's putting on a boxing display.
He's working the levels.
Working the levels indeed. He is really, really displaying some excellent boxing here. Oh, and another big left.
So off that little break there, Burke drops his hands and Mitchell takes advantage of it.
Yeah, Burke has a decided speed disadvantage. He's wobbled again. He's on his bicycle. He's running. He's trying to get his legs back. He got out of the corner. Good for Burke. Good work.
Mitchell looks like he's just at target practice
now.
Yeah,
I think this round could really be the one that Mitchell sends him home in.
Burke doing a little clinching, catching his breath.
Smart.
Trying to, yeah.
I'd clinch as much as possible.
Absolutely, he has to. He has to regain his time.
Well,
he's, you know.
Body shot looked like it affected him there a little. He's standing a little different after that jab reached his solar plexus. He's covering up his body. He's selling out completely to cover up those ribs or maybe that gut. Something's hurt him.
The jab landed, got through there.
Jab lands hard.
Khalil Mitchell's got a stiff jab, guys.
Oh, the right snuck through. Burke doesn't want to get in a shootout at this point. Not at all. He doesn't have the firepower. He needs to fight a tactical fight,
stay in close, try to slow Mitchell down, try to survive, get his legs back under him. Yeah, if he gets in a shootout, he doesn't have the right size gun.
Robert Burke lands an uppercut, but Mitchell comes back.
Will we lose a mouthpiece?
I think Mitchell lost it on the uppercut.
Oh, wow.
Robert Burke landed a solid uppercut.
Any break you can get, right? I mean, Burke should be happy for that. He got a little time to regain his composure. He's throwing some looping body shots that just don't have Mitchell concerned.
Mitchell lands two of his own. A little short uppercut there. Khalil Mitchell threw that one from the parking lot.
Yeah.
And then Burke came back from the other parking lot.
I like it. I tell you what, I mean, this fight's been one-sided, but it's been a good fight.
Khalil Mitchell has been maintaining most of the control. I like him to stay fundamental, stay solid. When you get wild like that, you leave yourself open.
Yeah.
Robert Burke makes it through round three.
Credit to him for that.
Absolutely.
He is taking some heavy, heavy shots. Let me ask you, Billy, does this fight go the distance, yes or no? We got three more rounds to go.
At the beginning of that third round, I would have said, oh, absolutely not.
Right.
Burke
is tough.
He's from Ireland.
Yeah, there's something about those
guys,
huh?
He's been around Conor McGregor. He's been around those fighters over there. Wow. You know, he's tough.
Well, and even with that heavy knockdown, I mean, he jumped up. He didn't get up. Jumped up. He's got a dog in him for sure.
No, and you know, he's quality enough to be able to stop Khalil Mitchell. If he gets wild, leaves himself open,
which
Mitchell
done
needs
a little
to stay
towards the end, yeah.
Yeah, you know, he threw that one from his ankles, another one from, you know, stay composed.
Round four, here we go.
Burke comes right out there firing.
Yeah, nice body shot.
So he's throwing that right hand to the body, and his head's staying on line.
Right.
Mitchell's countering with that left hook. He's missed it the last two times. There it is again. He threw it, and Mitchell, he's leaving himself open after he throws.
That's a great read, Billy. Yeah, you're right, and you can see it every time it's there. And Mitchell's figured that out quickly. Mitchell has downloaded the information and is using it to his advantage. Oh, wow. Big windup on that.
Mitchell squatting with that left hand and just throwing from his hips. Look at that.
Yeah, he wants to get him out of there, no question.
Yeah.
Mitchell would like the KO tonight. He doesn't want to see this go to decision.
No.
Yeah, Burke's punches just right now don't have any pop on him. To his credit, he's throwing punches out there, but not a lot on those. Mitchell will stay right in there, stay in the pocket where he can deliver his own offense.
Mitchell in firm control. He's got Burke on the ropes there. Not on the ropes, got him back towards the ropes. Nice body shot by Burke.
Yeah, Burke's working a
strategy.
That
big body shot with another left hook. The right hand of Burke is dropping to protect those ribs. Khalil Mitchell found a home for it.
Big power on those shots. Burke fighting back.
He's not giving up.
No, he's not. And some of those shots have landed. I mean, to his credit, I can't feel good. Oh,
Mitchell coming back on the ropes.
This is fun, Billy.
The fans are loving it here in Chattanooga, Tennessee.
I mean, this is what you come for. Burke looking a little wobbled, but still showing some great head movement.
One, two. Now, Khalil Mitchell should come in. Yeah. There he goes.
Yeah, don't play with your food. That's going to be a push, right?
That's not a knockdown. That's not a knockdown.
What's Danny saying?
He's telling him that's not a knockdown. Burke thought it was.
I don't know that's what he's saying, Billy. It looks like he's saying that's it.
Oh, he's stopping it. Danny Ziemba is stopping the fight.
What do you think about that?
So, I kind of have mixed emotions about it in a sense. But
no protest from the corner, but.
No, Burke was tired.
Jeez. So, what are your mixed feelings? I don't like that stoppage. I mean, I love Danny Ziemba like a brother, but. I mean, the guy's still fighting. He was just throwing bombs 10 seconds ago. But again, with no protest from the corner, I think the corner saw something.
All right,
maybe
I'm going to the ring.
We'll see, Billy. T-shirt time in the ring right now. Nothing wrong with that. Get a free T-shirt. I wonder if the girls have strong enough arms to get them over here to us, boys. What do you think? We're way back here. We're in the cheap seats. They look athletic, though. And they also appear to be out of shirts. So I think our chances are nil. Well, we'll live to fight another day, just as will Mr. Burke, the fighting pride of Dublin, Ireland. Robert Burke getting a round of applause from the crowd. Everyone saw his toughness on display. Knocked down several times throughout the fight. Continued to get back up. Tell you what, Khalil Mitchell, he is the real deal. We'll throw it to Walter in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, this hard-fought battle lasted 2 minutes and 34 seconds into round number 4 before veteran referee Danny Ziemba holds the contest. Oh, for your winner by way of technical knockout and still undefeated, Khalil Mitchell.